reasons why people give up on their weight loss journeys and end up not being successful. In other words, why do people fail at their weight loss journeys? If you're interested in more information about this, stay with me. Hi, this is Amy at amycommonsensesouthern.com. I hope you're doing well today. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I upload 2 to 3 times a week. So as we're getting started, let me be very clear about something. I am not a nutritionist. I am not a dietitian. I am not a psychologist or a psychiatrist. I'm just somebody who has lost a lot of weight and I've been successful in maintaining that loss. Therefore, people notice that, and so I end up in a lot of conversations about my weight loss journey, and then people share their experiences. And this is just totally my experience of what I've observed in having those conversations with people. So please keep that in mind. That's my little disclaimer as I start this. Reason number one is that people say I can't a whole lot. And they're not talking about goals they can't reach. They're talking about their current plan. If your current plan causes you to be saying a lot, I can't, as in I can't have this, I can't have that, meaning what you're allowed to eat, then what you're saying is often an indication of what you're thinking, because you have to think something before you say it, right? So if you're saying I can't a lot, that thought, I can't, is going through your head a good bit. And when you're saying I can't do something, I'm not allowed to have something, I'm not supposed to have something, then I think it stops feeling like a choice and starts feeling like a mandate. That's one thing that I think I have been healthy about in my thinking about my weight loss journey, is that there are certain things I choose to have. So even if you're on a program that restricts certain things that you're not supposed to eat in order to be successful on that program, change your thinking about it. So instead of thinking to yourself, I can't have that, think to yourself, I choose not to have that. I'm making a decision not to eat that. Have your thinking be more about what's on your terms as opposed to what you can't have, what someone else is telling you can't have, what's being imposed on you. Now, I'm not saying that you shouldn't be on a program that tells you that you should not eat a certain thing. Weight Watchers is what I'm doing, and WW does not tell me that there's anything that can't be eaten. So I'm not saying that, oh, you should do Weight Watchers because that's better than everything else, because it doesn't restrict anything. And you will be successful on whatever plan you do if you do that plan, because you're going to lose weight if you are on a caloric deficit. Doesn't matter which way you're doing it. Again, I'm not a dietitian, I'm not a nutritionist. That's just, it just is. And therefore, whatever plan you do, you're going to be successful most likely if you stick to that plan. Just make sure that you're doing it on your terms. So it would probably help you a lot if you stop thinking, I can't, regardless of what program you're doing, and think about what you're choosing to do. The second reason that I find that people tend to give up on their weight loss or wellness plan, trying to make too many changes at once. Look, if you've been a person that you've never broken a sweat on purpose, if you have not really thought about what you're eating, you're used to kicking back a couple of sodas a day, and then all of a sudden you're going to work out 5 times a week, and you're going to cut sodas out altogether, and you're going to reduce your sodium, or just whatever bunch of things it is you think you're going to do all at one time, you might want to just slow down a little bit. Now, all of those things are admirable. Those are great changes to make, but just think about perhaps implementing 1 or 2 at a time. Up your water intake. Reduce your soda intake when you're ready. You know, I didn't go from drinking 2 or 3 sodas a day, which I was doing, to suddenly just drinking plain water out of the tap all at once. If you can do that, that's great. So personally, for example, I had to cut back the sodas and then replace with something else. So I drank a lot of tea. I transitioned myself. I did not start working out from day one of my wellness plan. I lost a little bit of weight through diet alone, and then that success made me excited about getting out there and working on my fitness a little more, or being a little bit more conscious about what I was doing. So if you try to make a bunch of changes at once and you realize that that is stressing you, you might want to dial it back just a little bit. Not that you're not trying to make changes that need to be made, you are. It's just that people become overwhelmed and they give up. I have talked to more than one person who's been all excited about what they were gonna do, and then they ultimately got frustrated and gave up. The third thing has to do with sustainability. So if you believe that the secret to your weight loss success is some pill or powder or supplement or something that you have to go out and buy, if that is what you believe is the secret to your weight loss success, what about when you reach your goal? Are you going to continue on with that pill or purchased product for the next 60 years of your life? What happens if that product is no longer manufactured? What if that company is bought out by another company and the formula changes? What if your financial situation changes such that it's no longer an option for you to be able to obtain that product? What will you do long term? So it was my personal choice that I did not want my weight loss success to be based on something specific that I had to go out and buy other than what's in the realm of healthy whole foods. I'm not saying that maybe some of those things don't have a place in your weight loss journey, they may, but if it is what you believe is what's making you successful, then what about when you reach that goal and thinking about your maintenance and long term? I don't want to discourage you if you have been using something that you think is just making all the difference. I mean, I'm not talking about a certain brand of yogurt you buy. I'm not talking about kale. I'm talking about like some specific product or supplement that you've been purchasing, that you have been depending on, and you believe that to be your secret to your success. So I'm not just guessing and making up things here. I'm basing this on actual people that I've known who reached their goal using a particular product and then quit using it, and then they gained their weight back. So anyway, I hope this has been helpful to you. Whatever program you're on, stop it with the can't language in your head. Make sure that whatever you're doing is on your terms and it's your choice. Think about how many changes you're making all at one time and the sustainability of what you're doing long term throughout the rest of your life. That's why we talk about that whatever program we're doing, they're not a diet, they're a lifestyle change. I've committed to eating healthy whole foods and making sure that I don't overeat. That's part of my lifestyle now. Go ahead and click that subscription button and the notification bell so you don't miss a thing, and I'll see you next time at Amy Common Sense Southern.